You come back from a couple days break after WrestleMania, do the first TV, and they hand me a white frock coat like the cosmetologists wear, and handed it to me and go, now you're the barber. I was like, seriously? What is the barber?
Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Brutus the Barber Beefcake indeed.
I was upset. I mean, if you look at the first pictures, we went on to a location in a barbershop, the look on my face, I was so upset. 2-3 years of Brutus Beefcake, red hot. Now all of a sudden, I didn't know what to do. There was a little period there where I was panicking. I didn't know what the people are gonna buy it, what's gonna happen. It just it was all new territory for me. And just winging it by the seat of my pants, I'm doing, you know, just going for it.
And I can be the best barber the world has ever seen.
Oh, he's got the scissors out.
It wound up being bigger than anybody had ever imagined.
The clippers are gonna be clipping. And the strut's gonna be strutting, man.
I'm walking out to the arenas with the thousands of people around, and you have to project, you have to be animated, and the little scissors just weren't making it. So I thought, what about hedge clippers? The people would just explode when they saw the big scissors coming out, bam, bam.
These babies here are the tools of the trade. Every good barber knows how to use his tools.
Cut people's hair in the ring every time, every match, every match, every match, a haircut, a haircut.
He won't like this, Jess. This is horrible.
I put the special sharpeners on these suckers right here, and they're gonna cut you.
Sometimes I would really brutalize them too. I'd clip a big patch of hair out of the top of their head. They'd have to shave their heads.